What do movies such as Mowgli and Dumbo have in common? Let's address the elephant in the room today. Now, these creatures are keystone species, basically because they help maintain the ecosystem and they help balance that through trampling down on the ground, you know? And those things have heavy feet. They unearth the soil and they kind of help in planting trees. With their huge bodies, they help push down trees, and they do this mainly to get nutrients from the roots. But while they do this, the seeds kind of fall from the tree's flowers, and they therefore help planting the trees. Now, I'd love to talk about the big five, but I'm all about appreciating small things. So today, I'm just going to give you a fun little fact about the small five. For example, we have the elephant shrews, buffalo weaver, ant lion, rhinoceros beetle, and the leopard tortoise. Now, elephants apparently cannot jump. So, yeah, because of their shaft. It's unlike ours. They're the only beings that, you know, can jump. That's why they are not able to jump into conclusions and stuff like that. Now, these guys also help us know what seasons there are, because they shift when it's during the raising seasons and stuff like that. So they can be used to detect climate change. These creatures are also emotional beings. Like, they mourn and cry for their dead, which is quite amazing, you know? Think about it. They're kind of like humans. And that's why one Nat Geo, Paula Kahumba, says the Maasai call them literally humans. During the dry seasons, these guys use their tusks to dig for water. I found that really cool because it's sometimes really hard to dig through the ground. And sometimes when they move through the forest, they create a way for animals and organisms and even us tourists who go and visit the national parks, all thanks to the elephants. They always do this. The trunk serves as a nose, a hand, an extra foot, a signaling tool, and something to gather food from like the trees and stuff, and for siphoning water, digging, and dusting. These people also have amazing skills. The elephant families are only led by females, so that says a lot about how we as humans should let the government be led, just saying. They also don't need much sleep, and they are creative at communications. They also love good long showers, so they're very clean, and they have a very record long pregnancy period. So that's just mainly it about biodiversity. These guys are the apex of maintaining the ecosystem, and that's why I believe they represent the best type of biodiversity ever. Cheers. I hope you enjoyed. Like, subscribe, and comment below.